encourage. We are here to encourage them. Amen? We are here to support the teenager. And God is going to use this teenager here to touch the teenager over there. Amen? So please, teenager, the program is for you and it's for your future. Please, if you have anything to ask, prepare yourself. Amen? So you are going to join me to welcome our pastor, Pastor David. Please celebrate him. You are welcome, sir. Next to our daddy, our guest speaker is Pastor Mrs. Juliet Onose. Celebrate him. You are welcome, ma'am. May the Lord bless you. Amen.
Amen.
We are here because of the teenagers. We want them to know who they are in the Lord. We want to take them out of the world to prepare them to know that they have a brighter future. So our topics today are based on encourage. We are going to encourage them. This is our first question we put to our daddy, Pastor David. May the Lord bless you, sir. We are going to encourage the teenager. We want to support them. How can we support them with this end time that we are now, that they will not be wayward, they will have a brighter future. They are not very blessed. Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
This is one of my eyes as we pray. Our Father, we thank you this morning. Blessed be your holy name. Thank you for bringing us together as a family. Lord, you said we should train up our children, the way they should go. And when they go up, we shall go to the path of the Lord. Father, Lord, we are here for the purpose of the teenagers. As we discuss, as we speak, let your name be glorified in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Oh Lord, open their hearts, open their mindset, that Lord will be able to receive your word and digest it in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
We cover the garden in the name of the Father,
Amen.
Of the Son,
Amen.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
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 Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Concerning the question, how are we going to encourage the teenagers that they won't be wayward in the future? So that they won't be wayward in the future. It's very important to know that our children, the teenagers, they are the future of tomorrow. What we need to do as parents, as guardians, as teachers, is first of all, we teach them the way of the Lord. The Bible tells us in the book of Genesis, when God was speaking about Abraham, he said, I know Abraham, he will command his children after me. He was saying that Abraham will teach his children the way of the Lord. So when we are able to teach our children the way of the Lord, it will guide them in the future. Let them have the fear of God, which is the number one thing. When they have the fear of God, they will be able to depart from evil. According to the book of Proverbs, he said the fear of God is to depart from evil. So when you have the fear of God, it takes you away from evil. So the number one way is teaching our children the way of God. Praise God.
Amen. Can we celebrate our daddy in the house?
thank you very much, sir. May the Lord help you, Jesus mighty. Amen. Teenagers, the teen, is there anything in the house? Yes. Celebrate yourself. Amen. I hope we all understand what our pastor is talking about now, teenagers, that we should try and listen to what the parents are talking about so that they will give you a full moral support. Amen. If you don't do what your parents want you to do, then that support you are looking for, how will you get it? Amen.
Amen.
I hope we are one here. Amen.
Amen.
So please try what is you are supposed to do. If your parents need your help, they will need your help. No way they will not need your help. So that they will give you that support that you will need in future. And whatever your senior ones is teaching you, either in your congregation, either in your community, either in your family, listen attentively. Don't go beyond what you are supposed to do. Amen. So that you have a brighter future. May the Lord help us to train you people in Jesus' mighty name. Is there anything that want to ask any question, teenager? If you want to ask any question or you don't understand what the meaning of support is talking about, do you have anything to ask or you have anything to say, or there's anything you don't understand, you want to know this moment, we are here because of you. Amen. Okay, as we are going to celebrate our mommy in the Lord, Pastor Moses Onose, Juliet Onose, put your hands together for me. Mommy, it goes like this. They want to have confidence. They want to beat themselves. So that if whatever the world wants to bring to confront them, they will know how to stand on their feet. They need that confidence. Without this confidence, Satan will still be putting fear inside them. Either they are mates in the school, we still be putting fear. In their community, they can still be putting fear. But we want to build a total confidence on them. How can they grab that confidence at this hour for them to know who they are? In the Lord help us, man. Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Teenager, celebrate yourself. Hallelujah. Just like what our mom has just asked, how can you build that confidence in yourself? You know, the world we are today, people tend to copy the world. And I remember God said in His word that we are in the world, but we are not of the world. By the time as a teenager, you are growing up as a teenager, and you begin to copy the system of the world, applying it to your life, it will not bring a good result. You all know 1 Peter 2:9. You sing it every time, you recite it every time. You know what the Bible says in 1 Peter 2:9. I think you know that. Teenager, you don't know what the Bible says? You know it. You know who you are. 1 Peter 2:9. He said you are a royal priesthood, a holy nation. God has called you out of darkness into one lost light. For you to build that confidence in yourself, you have to know who you are. You have to know that you are made in the image of God. You have to know the word of God. It is the word of God that can build confidence in any man. It is the word of God you can use to conquer the world that the world is preaching against God these days. Because out there in the world, there is nothing good to offer. Instead, they are turning the word of God in the opposite way. You see these days that the youth, devil has really positioned to take the news. But our children will not be part of it. They begin to introduce different things to them in the school. They begin to make them feel that a boy can marry, a man can marry a man. That they are born like that. But God has not created anyone. So to encourage you this morning, my teenagers, please, know who you are. The Bible said you are the head, not the tail. So the first thing that you need to know to build that confidence in you is to know the word. Study the word the way you study your books. Make sure create time for the word as you create time for your own works. And you start doing it, you will begin to build confidence in yourself. Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Pastor. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, my Pastor, Mrs. Juliet Solo said. I hope you all understand this word of encouragement. They have already encouraged us that we should study our Bible. We should get closer to God. We should know who we are. Because we are called out of darkness into the light of the Lord. Amen. So prepare yourself on your way going up. You need to know God so that anything Satan is trying to bring towards you, you will know how to send it back to Satan. That you, this is not your own way. Your God did not bring you to this world for this. Amen. See, the gender you like it or not, we are in end time. Amen. So you will be seeing different type of character, different type of attitude, different type of people. You were taught last time that you are not the difference between what? God bless you. Celebrate yourself. So, amen. So you know who you are in the Lord now. You are the light of this world. So you will not be taken into darkness in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
So you need to help yourself by yourself. Amen?
Amen.
So if you can grab all these points now, you can grab it the way you are grabbing your knowledge in your school. Then you are now a winner. Amen.
Amen.
So please think, prepare yourself. Because God really needs you. You are not in this world by mistake. You are here for a purpose. And in Jesus' name, that purpose will be accomplished in your life in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
You will be used as a good example in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not be wayward in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
God will use you that is you that are here now as a point of contact to touch other teenagers outside there. Amen?
Amen.
I hope you all understand what the meaning of out of darkness into the light of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Is there any one of you that have any question to ask before we go further? We are here because of you this afternoon. May the Lord help us. Is there anything you don't understand? Or is there anything that is bothering you? Or as we are going along, you want full commitment. Amen. So we need your help now by yourself to help yourself and to help others. Because your question here, that an answer, we touch other teenagers over there. And that is why you are here. For you to touch other teenagers, for you to use you as a vessel. Amen. For God to use you of this generation to conquer the world. That is why, that is the purpose of you being here this afternoon. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
As our mommy said before that, in the school sometimes the teachers about that a boy can marry another boy.
Como nuestra maestra dijo antes que en el colegio nos enseñan que un hombre puede casarse con un hombre.
For example, like me, I have a friend that is a boy that likes another boy, for example.
Yo tengo un amigo en el colegio que a él le gustan también los chicos.
I don't really play with him, but I consider him as my friend. So what should I say to him? I should be looking at him badly, or I should tell him that what he's doing is wrong, or I should just forget about him.
El equipo de médico de grado le digo que lo que está haciendo está mal o me olvido de él.
Put your hands together for her.
Say it better. That's a very wonderful question. Amen. That question we first go to, it is mommy that raised that topic. And that question we will go to our pastor, Pastor David, before we go to Pastor Mrs. Juliet. And I say, may the Lord help us.
Amen. Praise God. The question you ask is a technical question. In such a case, you don't have to run away or stay away from such persons. According to the Bible, what the Bible tells me in the book of 2 Timothy, 1 verse 7, I read from the translation of the Living Bible, it says, "For the Holy Spirit, God's gift, that is in you, does not want you to be afraid of people. Does not want you to be afraid of people, but to be wise and strong." Praise God. "But to be wise and strong, and to love them and enjoy being with them." To be wise and strong. In such a case, you don't have to stay away from them, but what you need to do is you show them love. We are talking about encouragement. And what the Bible tells us in the book of Isaiah 35. Let's open the book of Isaiah 35. Isaiah 35 verse 3. Amen. Isaiah 35 verse 3. I couldn't read it because of my time. Verse 3 and 4. He said, from the translation of the Living Bible, he said, "With this news, bring cheer to all discouraged ones." You see, some people, they are weak. Some people, they are weak. And the Bible tells us in verse 1, "Encourage those who are afraid. Tell them, be strong, fear not, for your God is coming to destroy your enemy, he is coming to save you." If you look at the King James, it tells you, strengthen the feebleness. Praise the living God. Some people, they are weak. What they need from you is encouragement. You encourage them in truth. Praise the living God. You talk to them in truth. Because what the society has fed them with is destroying them. The society tells them that what they are doing is normal. But you, as a child of God, through the Holy Spirit that dwells in you, you know that it is wrong. So what you need to do is to encourage them in truth, you tell them the truth, let them know the truth. Praise the living God. When you run away from them, there's no way you can speak the truth to them. The only way you can speak the truth to them is when you are close to them, you speak it to them, but don't be like them. Praise God. Amen.
Celebrate our daddy.
Celebrate our daddy. Celebrate him. Celebrate him. Amen. Are we blessed with that answer? Amen. Amen. That is the end of this world.
and we will not be part of the world in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God will need you and as a light to shine on that darkness. A beautiful question and a marvelous answer. We all know that was Sodom and Gomorrah. Even if we say the truth, as Holy Scripture says, that truth will set us free. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
So tell them the truth. If they take it, if they don't take it, but God have already sent you and have already delivered that message. By you running away from the answer, what daddy have said, you are not doing that work that God called you into this world to do. Amen.
Amen.
So if you touch their life, they might not agree with you at that same time. But when they go in a silent place or in a secret place, they might think about it. Is that not my mate that's talking like a child of God like that? It's like I should follow her steps. It's like the God that is serving is the best. Amen. When they have that thought inside them, amen, when you are growing with that your lesson, you will see that you are doing the will of your father. Amen.
Amen.
And then you will start going from glory to glory, and you will be a good example to this end time, to this world, to this wicked world. Then you can bring all the people that Satan have already shamed or put in the darkness, you are now bringing them into the lights of the world. And that reward from your heavenly Father will surely touch you and your family and your community and your friends and your loved ones. You will all be happy together. Amen.
Amen.
May the Lord help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Then we are going to go to our mommy now, Pastor Mrs. Juliet Onose, to bless us in the next 5 minutes with a good and beautiful answer to our question too. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Like our daddy has already said it all. You cannot run away from them. If you have such friends, it's your duty as a Christian to pass the message of God to them. It's not really easy because I've met somebody like that.
Just be practical.
And as I was talking to him, he told me that he started it when he was 11 years old. And that he cannot be able to go with a woman. That he has tried it so many times, but he could not. And I told him, if you really want to leave it, you can leave it. It is a spirit that comes into him. And that spirit also can be cast out. So if you have such a friend that is indulging in such acts, make sure you preach the gospel to that person that it is a sin. God does not hate them. God only hates the sin. God loves everybody. God loves sinners. But God hates sin. Praise the Lord. And another way you can be able to achieve it, maybe when you talk to the person and it's not giving you ears. Always pray for the person. You're praying, you're interceding for him or her, can make him or her to turn to Christ. Are you getting what I'm saying? Teenager, are you hearing me? Always pray for such a friend. Let's open our Bible to our side. Isaiah chapter 30. I'm just reading verse 1. Isaiah chapter 30, verse 1. He said, woe to the rebellious children, said the Lord, that take counsel, but not of me, and that cover with a covering, but not of my spirit, and that they add sin to sin. The spirit of homosexual is not the spirit of God.
Ese espíritu no es espíritu de Dios.
And these days, it so much pains me that the youth, the devil is really getting the youth.
He visto a muchos adolescentes que están en ese espíritu, que tienen ese espíritu.
Have increased me in my spirit.
Y me hace daño en mi espíritu.
Because if this generation should continue like this,
porque si esta generación sigue así,
I don't know how the end will be like.
No sé cómo va a acabar.
So we, as the children of God, that carry the light and the spirit of God.
Nosotros como hijos de Dios y tenemos la luz de Dios.
What we are supposed to do to go out there and speak to them.
Lo que tenemos que hacer es salir ahí y hablar con ellos.
You know a lot of them in your school.
No solo los de tu colegio.
You have a lot of them as friends.
Tienen muchos de ellos como amigos.
Don't run from them.
No te olvides de ellos.
Even tell them that Jesus loves them.
Diles que Dios les quiere.
Tell them that God loves them.
Diles que Dios les quiere.
Only God hates the heart.
Solo Dios odia su corazón.
He hates the sin.
Odia los pecados.
And begin to take it as a point of contact to reach them through prayers.
Y tienes que hacerles saber con oraciones.
Because they need our prayers.
Porque necesitan las oraciones.
Because unknown to them, they are ignorant of what they are doing.
Porque no saben lo que están haciendo.
One argued with me and told me that he was born to be a woman.
Uno estaba diciendo, un chico dijo que él había nacido para ser.
He has gone to medical and checked the hormones and he's supposed to be a woman.
Él ha ido al médico y se ha mirado y ha
nacido una mujer. And I told him that that is the lie from the pit of hell.
Y él dijo que eso es una mentira.
That God does not make mistakes.
Que Dios no se equivoca.
If God created you to be a man, He created you to be a man.
Si Dios ha creado para ser un hombre, te
ha creado para ser un hombre. If God made someone to be a man, and put the hormones of a woman inside him.
No hay ninguna manera que Dios te cree para ser un hombre y que
the Bible says the ways of God are perfect.
Dios, la palabra de Dios dice que los
caminos de Dios. Please, teenager, don't behave like them.
Por favor, chavos, no os comportéis como ellos.
If you behave like them, you can't win them.
Si os comportáis como ellos, no podéis ganar su arma.
If you do things that they do, you can't win them. If you talk like them, you can't win them.
Si hablas como ellos, no puedes ganar.
Anywhere you go as a teenager,
donde vayas como un adolescente,
always make your stand known that you are Christian.
Siempre tienes que hacer saber que eres un cristiano.
And I also want to encourage the parents. Maybe many of them are watching because this thing is not left for the teacher or the teenager teacher. But the parents have about 80% of play in the life of any child.
Los padres también tienen un 80% de su hijo.
Watching all over the world.
Si eres un padre en todo el mundo.
Please always talk to your children about Christ.
Siempre habla de tus hijos sobre Dios.
It's not easy, but place them before God.
No es fácil, pero tienes que hacerlo.
Speak to them the things that are good and the things that are bad.
Hay que saber lo que es bueno y lo que es malo.
I don't know if you can open our Bible to Deuteronomy.
Vamos a abrir la Biblia de Deuteronomio.
The only one. I just want to pick something there. Okay, I will read 37 to 38.
37 to
38. Because it's long, but let me start from 37. The only one, 37. He said, also the Lord was angry with me for your sake. Saying, thou also shall not go in thither. But Joshua the son of Nun, which standeth before thee, he shall go in thither. Encourage him, for he shall cause Israel to inherit it. Moreover, last verse 39, moreover, your little ones, which he said should be a prey, and your children, which in that day had no knowledge between good and evil, they shall go in thither, and unto them will I give it, and they shall possess it. What is this verse saying? God was talking to Moses.
En este versículo,
he said, I'm angry with you, Moses. Because of what you have done, you will see the promised land will not enter. He said, the little children, that's verse 39, here I'm going to. That have no knowledge of evil and good.
Will enter.
That means God cannot even spare the little children. Any teenager that already know what is good and what is bad and is doing the bad one is not going to enter the kingdom of God.
Cualquier adolescente que sabe lo que es bueno, lo que es malo y hace lo malo no va a entrar en
God is not saying going to say because you are a teenager. That's what he's saying. He's saying the one that have no knowledge of between good and evil, then we enter. So it is only little babies that do not have the knowledge of good and evil, they are spelled. But the ones that have the knowledge of good and evil and tend to be doing evil, the Bible says they will not enter the kingdom of God. So please, teenager, it is your homework. Present yourself as a light and speak to your friends. You have a lot of white friends. Talk to them.
Hablar con
ellos.
Que esa actitud
no
es de Dios.
And if they don't want to, they pray for them.
Y si no quieren escucharte,
deja para ellos.
Send me praise, mommy. Send me praise, mommy. Put your life more than that. Send me praise. Amen. Amen. I can see that through that your mommy. God Almighty has already touched us mightily, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
You see now that all of us are preparing to enter the kingdom of God, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
So we should do the right thing. May the Lord help us in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
We have, I think, Sister Ben, are you raising up your hand?
Yeah.
Over to you.
Thank you. Our pastor said, if we really want to change them, we should talk to them. And mommy said, we should talk to them and we shouldn't leave them. But what if those that have determined their mind that they are going to continue in this act, even though their parents are in this act, like some parents are separated and they are in this act. So there's a word that say, if you can't, it's either you leave them or you join them. So, In that situation, what can we do when they are determined they don't want to change? So if we leave them, is it a sin?
Put your hands together for the Lord. Celebrator. Celebrator. If I can hear you very well now. Sister, please, whenever teenager, whenever you come, introduce yourself. Amen. In the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Sister Blessing, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
If I can hear Sister Blessing very well, if they are already been initiated, they have already went deep inside it, is there any way you can bring them out? Because this is a big commitment. Even there are some people, they met that act in their house. Their parents are doing the same thing. So therefore, they were born to be doing the same thing. But as our mommy has said, that there is nothing God cannot do, but let's hear from them. Amen. Put your hands together for the Lord. Our daddy will be here for 2 minutes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
When you talk to them, most of them, they belong in the act, or they were born into it, or their parents are involved in it. We are not talking of you force them, you know. You don't force anybody, praise God. The Bible was telling us in the book of Deuteronomy, God was telling the children of Israel, I said before you good and evil, but I prefer you choose good so that we live long. Praise the living Lord. So what you need to do as a believer is to speak the word. It's not led for the Holy Spirit.
Praise
God. Speak the word, it's not left for the Holy Spirit. You cannot force anybody to change. Praise God. It's only whenever you are opportune, you speak the word to him or you speak the word to her. So if he or she decides he's not going to change, it's none of your business. But what you need to do, if you really love that friend, you keep praying for him or her. Praise the Lord. That's where the prayer of intercession comes in. You intercede on behalf of such persons. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Celebrate that in the house.
Celebrate that in the house. I hope we are blessed with that answer. May the Lord help us. If you remember our last topic, the difference between sheep and goat, we are taught how to intercede for one another, isn't it? Even our mommy, even daddy, friends, community, even in our church, if you see anybody that is going into the acts that is not of the Lord, we are taught to intercede, to pray, because God wants to hear from each and every one of us. As well, as a saint, are we not a saint? We are all saints, that's where we are here. So is there anybody that wants to go out of the will of the Lord, you meet up and pray for that particular person, and God will surely hear us. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Daddy. Thank you, Mommy. May the Lord bless your home, your family, your hard work in Jesus' mighty name. It is not easy to leave all what they are doing and come over here to touch our life. It's a real big touch. And God Almighty will touch their own home too in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Is there any other question from the teenager? Is there anybody that have anything to ask? Or anything you don't understand in a school, in your community, among your friends, among your family? Is there any one of us that want to ask anything or raise any question? Can we go further? Amen. Okay, then we, in the next 10 minutes now, amen, we will go to our daddy and our mommy to feed us more, to blow our mind again, what is called hope. Amen. Amen. So we first go to our daddy now to touch us concerning hope. You still have hope. Then for sure, we have hope. Hope to finish our education. Hope to preach the word of God. Hope to come out of darkness into the light of the Lord. Hope to stand on our feet. To hope to bring one our loved ones out of their wayward way into the way of the Lord. Hope to stand together with the ones that we love so that we don't lose them. Because if there is no hope, there is no future. So we'll first go to our daddy now, Pastor David, to feed us concerning what is called hope. May the Lord help us in Jesus' mighty name. Please celebrate our daddy. Celebrate. You can do more than that. Celebrate him. Amen. Thank you, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Hope is what motivates every man or woman on earth. When you have hope, it changes you. Those that are hopeless are those that give up easy. So when you have hope, you have faith. You have strength to fight, to keep on moving. Praise the living God. So hope plays a big role in our life. Hope is what takes you from where you are to your higher heights. Many of you here, or many of us here, we are able to be maybe engineers, doctors, name it. The only thing that can motivate you is your hope. So your hope must not die. Don't allow the enemy to steal your hope from you. Don't allow the enemy to destroy your hope. The moment they steal your hope, you are finished. Praise the living God. So when you have hope, you are able to read. When you have hope, when you are discouraged, you encourage yourself. When you have hope, even when people mock you, you still go ahead. Because you know where you are going. Praise the living God. So I want every teenager, every one of us, to have hope for our hope to be alive. We are talking of the topic encouragement. Encouragement also has to do with hope. Encouragement is giving support, confidence, or hope to someone. Hope is reassuring the person that yes, you are not finished. Hope is reassuring you that yes, you have life, you can face tomorrow. We used to sing a song, because he lives, I can face tomorrow. What does it mean? Because Christ lives, you have that faith that Christ lives, and it gives you hope that yes, tomorrow, and no matter what comes my way, I will surely triumph. So as you are growing up, you need it by teenagers. You need it to be able to establish yourself in the future. You need hope to be able to focus on what you are doing. You need hope for you to be able to prevail in life. So don't allow the enemy to steal your hope from you in any way. There are some words that might come to you that you cannot make it. You are like this, you are not like that, you are supposed to be like what, this one, that one. No, those are the way the enemy steal hope from you. The way God created you is how God wants you to be. God created you in a unique way. Praise the living God. So your hope must remain in you. Your hope is what you build on. Your hope must be alive. Praise the living God.
Celebrate our head in the house. Celebrate. You can do more than that. Amen. Put your hands together. Our last question, we go to our mommy. Hello.
Hi.
Our last question, we go to our mommy, Pastor Mrs. Onose. Hello. Amen.
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 Okay, mommy, this question goes like this. Hope will help the teenager to develop their ambition. Because there are some of them that they have a future, a career to follow. But because of the community where they find themselves, or the family within, or the friends they are moving with, they were discouraged not to follow that particular diagram they have to follow. Is there any way, we are talking about to encourage them, encouragement. Is there any way you would encourage the teenager not to mind the community, not to mind the society, not to mind the friend, but to make sure they focus their attention on whatever that diagram they have in within them? There are some of them, right from the time they were 7 years, they have been planning, when I grow, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, but along the way they are going off, where they find themselves, they were discouraged. Mommy, do you believe there are some people that will say, you want to do that particular thing? Somebody do it and that particular person failed. What do you want to go and do in that area? Please, is there any way you can help us so that you energize our spirits to face the diagram that we have been drawing concerning this future, and to wait, let everything, anything, anywhere you meet yourself or whatever people are saying concerning this your future, you wait aside and focus your attention wherever that you plan to go, in your plan app, make sure you get there. Mommy, can you please help us to pick some points out and encourage them? Cannot help us.
Yeah, like what I understand from what Tommy is saying,
our daddy has explained everything concerning what hope means. You must not let your hope die as a teenager. A lot of us, when we're growing up, we have a lot of things in our hearts. I can use myself to say that there's nothing. I want to be a nurse. I want to be a doctor. But along the line, we fall out of the way. Why? Because we get ignorant of what God is saying. Teenager, first of all, I will advise you that whatever you want to do, let's say before God, let God with you. Are you hearing me? The book of Proverbs says, he said, acknowledge the Lord in all your ways, and he shall direct your path. Don't let anything come your way because you see your friends doing it. I want to try it. No. You have a greater future. You know, I told you just now, I said, I will give you as an assignment. You know, I'm talking about 1 Peter 2 1. Let that, just that 1 Peter 2 1. I don't want to see it. I know who I am. I'm working in power. Or maybe I'm a royal priesthood. Mm-hmm. Holding it. No, not just say it because people are saying it. Digest it and know what it means. If you digest that word into your heart, then you will see that there is nothing you cannot do. Are you getting what I'm saying? Hope is about trusting God. And when you trust God, there's a strength that comes in the your inner mind, it will come out from there. You see yourself doing things that you don't even think you can do. Because why? You hope in God. I think the Bible says in Psalm 20, so it says some trust in God. And you know, and some is shallow. It says, God, who you call upon the name of our Lord? Whatever you want to achieve in life, it is possible. Don't let any of your friends discourage you. Don't let anybody tell you that it's not possible. If you are first of all laid it before Christ and God said, go ahead and do this, then you must be strong. Determination will not come in. There's a saying that said, nothing good comes easy. If you go to check people that have made it in life, they will tell you their stories. That from the beginning, they almost gave up. From the beginning, they were discouraged. But because they hope in the name of God, and they hold on to the word of God, what is God saying about that thing? That is what will give you hope. If you said you want to become a lawyer, or you said you want to be the governor of Palma de Mallorca one day, and that is your dream as a teenager, let me tell you, you can achieve it. All what you know is believe in yourself. Whatever that can hinder somebody is yourself. Before anybody can discourage you, it is you that will first of all discourage yourself. God has not given up in you. God has not given up in you. Don't give up in yourself. When you begin to believe yourself that I can do it, instead of God, nothing shall be impossible. Use the word of God to guide whatever you want to achieve in life. No matter the discrimination, no matter what you will face, because definitely you will face it. You will see people that will tell you they are not even taking whites. It is you that black that you think will come and be the cause. Let me tell you, you can be. If somebody said Obama, a black man, will be the president of US, will you believe that? In a white country, a black man was in control. I want you to change your mentality from the day. If you are in the midst of white people and they are running you down, you are a negro, tell them
I've been begging for a purpose because I'm going higher. God created you to be a beggar because he wants to give you the power to control the whites. So please, don't discourage yourself. Let me say, I encourage myself in the Lord. If you read about David, you will see what David passed through. In 1 Samuel, the children of Israel, they came to take away everything that David has. All to his wife, his children, everything. They were crying, shedding tears. We help ourselves. Who will help us? But David got up again. And encourage himself in the Lord. But one thing in life for you to achieve whatever you want to achieve is that you determine. Whatever you want, make it obvious that that is what you want. Don't let anybody come and suggest a second choice to you. That is why a lot of people think they are Christian. Maybe from the beginning you said, I want to be a doctor. And as you see that the things is becoming tougher and tougher, it's not going through, somebody will suggest to you, why not be a cleaner? After all, from there, you will still end a living. Tell the person, I will be what I want to be. By the power of God. So be determined. I will pray after.
Celebrate yourself. From now on, start preparing yourself. Work out your dreams. You are not a failure. No matter what comes your way, no matter what they say, do not change your mind. God bless you. And you are already won.
Amen.
I hope we are all blessed with this topic this morning.
Yes.
Because we really need it, isn't it?
Yes.
Are we not all blessed?
Yes.
We are all blessed.
Yes.
And God will hear our prayer.
Yes.
So, keep it up, eh? Amen?
Amen?
God loves you. And he loves each and every one of us. Parents, viewer, we come to the end of the show. Parents at home, you are hearing us, we teenagers are saying, we need your 80% support so that this will be well with us, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
So therefore, please, parents, join hands together with us so that we will work out things and the name of the Lord will be glorified in our life. We have a lot of work to do as a teenager. We want to do the work of God. We want to develop our environment. We want to bring our friends out of their wayward acts. We want to put light where there is darkness. We have a lot of things to do for the Lord. So therefore, we cannot do it alone. God is helping us, and we need help of parents too. May the Lord help us in Jesus' mighty name. As we have come to the end of the show, encourage. Please, do not go away. By this time next week, on Saturday at the same time, 12 o'clock to 1 o'clock, beloved, you are going to meet with us, and we are going to come out again with another marvelous topic, that the name of the Lord will be glorified.
Amen.
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 May the Lord help us in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Our contact is on the screen. Please call. We need help. We need support. We need assistance. We need encouragement. We need all things that we make the name of the Lord to be glorified. May the Lord help us and help you too, and help all the teenagers outside there in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
We are going to call on our brother David to please come and give us a closing prayer. Come on. Put celebration. Amen. Put on together. Amen.
Please stand up in the name of the Lord. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father God, we thank you, Lord, for making us to have a chance to hear another one of your word, another one of your teachings, toward the teenagers, toward us, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you for giving us another tip, another way of support, so that we can build our life and do what we want to do to change this world in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, God, for helping us mentally and spiritually in any ways that you have helped us. We thank you, God, for everything you have done. You commit all of our lives into your hands to make us be what you want us to be.
Amen.
To make us fulfill our destiny.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. As we go on through our lives, learning of what we have learned today, oh God, don't let any power of the devil discourage us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let them die in the mighty name of Jesus. Don't let any power of discouragement to discourage us to go in another path and not in your own path in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Oh God, use us as an example in this world so we can be able to change the teenagers of today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father God, we thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus' mighty name of
Jesus.
In Jesus' mighty name of
Jesus. Amen. Celebrate the name of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Sister Fifi, for speaking in Spanish. May the Lord help you in Jesus' mighty name. That God that you believe in God in glory and the honor mommy. May the Lord help you keep your household in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
We see you next week, Saturday, at the same time. We are saying bye.